Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. In today's video, we are going to discuss about the snapshot report, how to generate a snapshot report in a HTML format. So we have earlier seen the videos on snapshot, that how to delete a snapshot on the vCenter, which is older than few days, right? Maybe 7 days or 15 days. So that video is already there in my YouTube channel. You can go and watch that. But today we are only generating a report in a HTML format. So how to generate that report? So we are going to discuss about that. Now here, the first command we are using, that is connect -vi server. Now this command will help us to connect this PowerShell console to the vCenter. Okay. Now once we establish the connection between the vCenter, we can perform the rest of the commands on the vCenter. Okay. Now the first command we have completed. Now the second command we are using, we have created a file path variable. So whenever it generate the report, we want to save that report somewhere, right? So that is the reason we have created this file path, and on that path we are giving the name. Here you can see snapshot report, we have given the name of that HTML file. So it will take this data and it will save the HTML report into this path, and the file name will be like this. Okay. Now the third command which we have used is like the, we have created a snapshots variable, and into that variable we are collecting all the VM snapshot details. So that is the reason the actual command here we are using is a get -vm, then pipe, then get -snapshot, and then again pipe, and then we are only selecting few object properties, that is the description, created, VM, VM size. Okay. Now once we collect this data, we have to we have to utilize that in a correct form. So here we are getting the size. So let me show why we have created this function get -snapshot size. Okay, so let me show you here. So my console is already connected to the vCenter. Let me show you that. Okay, if I perform the get -vm command, it is showing me the result. Okay, now let me show you the vCenter console also. Okay, this much virtual machine is available. Now let me go further. Get -vm, then pipe get -snapshot. Okay. Now once I select this, okay, you can see here. We are getting very limited data, so it is not yet generated. Let's wait. Okay. So now you can see here we are getting the snapshot name, description, and the VM power state, but we want the virtual machine name as well in this, right? And the rest of the data. So what we are going to do here, so again let me, okay, so again let me put a pipe select -object. Okay, and here I'm putting asterisk. Now you can see here we have got so many details that we don't want that. We need a few details. Now we are getting here, if you see the earlier report, right, we are getting the snapshot name, description, and the power state of the virtual machine, but we also need here the virtual machine name, okay, and the size of the snapshot. So where we will get that, right? So we are getting that snapshot size here in the property, you can see here, but it is a very long number, so that is the reason we have created this function here, get -snapshot size, and that we are using here to format the number whatever is coming as a size. Okay, so we don't need this much detail. We need proper number that we can understand. Okay, hey, my snapshot is a 500 MB or 1 GB, something like that. Okay, so that is the reason we have created this function, and it will resize, or maybe it will reduce the number whatever it is showing, and it will show us the data in GB or MB. Now here we are generating the HTML report, and you can see here we have created a variable as a date, so we can get the current date, and then that date we can utilize for the rest of the HTML body. Okay, now here snapshot report we are generating here, we are giving the title here as a date. Okay, snapshot report for this date. Okay, now the second thing, we have created the HTML body here, font family, then the name of the font, then font size, which size we want. Okay, line height, font weight. Okay, so this detail we have already defined here. If you want to change that, you can change it. Then the table, what we are going to create on a HTML page that is already defined here. TH means table header and TD means table data. Okay, so whatever the data we are collecting from that command, the snapshot command, we will put here in the table data. Okay, so basically here again, whatever the data we have collected in the variable HTML message, okay, in the snapshot, so we are going to create a new variable that is the HTML message, and then we are going to convert the data into the HTML format. So we have already collected snapshot detail into this, so we are using the same data as a variable, and then we are applying the filter here. So we are giving the pipe select vm created. Okay, so this properties we are using as it is. Okay, and here the snapshot size we want into a different format. So the table header that we are using is a size. Okay, so label we have given here, and the expression we want from get hyper snapshot size. So here we have already created a function for that. Okay, because we don't want that longer number into the size. And once we have that, then we are using the description as it is, and we are again giving the pipe and then sort the data with created date in the descending order. Okay, now here again we are giving the pipe and we are saying hey, convert to the HTML, and hyphen head we are giving the header. Okay, so whichever the HTML page will be created, the header will be the same that what we have defined here. Okay, now the HTML report we are formatting. Okay, so we have again created a report variable, and again we are using the format hyphen HTML body command. Okay, and the property that we are, the variable which we are using is the HTML message. Now the same we are going to save into the some file, right? And the path we have already defined here in the top, you can see here. Okay, so now whatever the data and we have collected and we have converted into the HTML format, that will be saved in this path. So we have again used the same variable dollar report, and then out file hyphen path the file path. Okay, now here we are using the right hyphen host, which is the custom the custom message, right? So it will show that hey, your snapshot report has been saved to this file location. So whenever you run the command, it will capture the path from here and it will show the same path here. Okay, now whenever you are working on a custom method, you always remember one thing. Okay, there is no data validation here. I'm sharing this information as a precaution. Okay, because if something fails here, okay, and it won't generate the data, still it will show that okay, your snapshot report has been saved to this location, because this is a custom method. If you want that custom message to be first validated and then only it will show, then you have to use the if command, then you have to check whether there is a file generated on that path or not, and then you get say okay, if this file path is equal to true, then you like write host, then your snapshot file saved to this location. This is just for the additional information. Okay, and the last command we are using here, that is a disconnect to the from the vCenter console. Okay, the PowerShell session. So let me run the command, and then you can see how the report is getting generated. So I'm already connected to the vCenter, but let me disconnect first. Okay, so disconnect hyphen vi server. Okay, let's do all. Fine. Okay, now I'm running the script here. Okay, you can give the custom user input here to put to enter the vCenter name. So multiple report, if they are working on a multiple vCenter, then it will be very easy for them to every time once the script is completed and when they open the script on the PowerShell, it will prompt for the user input. Okay, so our file is generated and we can open this file. Okay, and you can see here the file is generated. This was the previous report actually. Okay, and you can see here the snapshot report has been generated proper, and it is showing the size in the MP. Okay, and you can see here. So let me minimize this. I will not delete, close this report, and let me take one more snapshot here on the weekend. So in the CR, I'm going to take one more snapshot. You can see here the snapshot creation is completed. So let me go again here and run the script. Okay, it is asking me to again. Okay, your report has been saved. So let me again open the report. And let's see if the new data has been, you can see here, okay, PowerShell report. And so earlier weekly report we had opened, that is a snapshot test. Okay, so this is how you can generate a report, and you can use the, you know, PowerShell function to send a email as well whenever this file will be generated. So that will, I will show in the next lecture. So if you have any doubt or query, you can put into the comment box and I'll try to answer that. Thank you for watching the video.